Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heater mass transfer. Today, this is lecture number 119 on the topic conduction heat transfer. And the topic for today's discussion is again unsteady state heat transfer in infinite cylinder. So we recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we discussed the unsteady state heat transfer and use of the Heisler-Grober chart for solving problem on infinite slab or infinite plate. And in this session, we are going to discuss the use of Heisler-Grober chart for solving problem in infinite cylinder, of infinite length. The learning outcome for the session, for this lecture, the student will be able to solve problems using the Heisler and Grober chart on the infinite cylinder. And this is the cylinder of outer radius RO with the infinite length. And the cylinder is initially at temperature Ti. The everywhere within the cylinder, the for all value of R and time t equal to 0, the temperature is Ti. And suddenly the boundary conditions are changed. The solid is put into a liquid bath or exposed to the convection environment. Now the boundary conditions are at the center of the cylinder R equal to 0 for time t is greater than 0, dou t by dou r equal to 0. That is, there is no change in this temperature at the center. So the first derivative of the temperature equal to 0. And for outer surface, it is exposed to the convection environment. So, the minus k dou t by dou r equal to h into t minus t infinity. That is the boundary condition. And the governing equation for the cylinder, one-dimensional unsteady state heat transfer in a cylinder is 1 by r dou by dou r into dou t by dou r equal to 1 by alpha dou t by dou r. And this is the mathematical formulation of the present problem. Cylinder, one-dimensional steady-state heat transfer in a cylinder with the convection environment. And to solve the problem, we have to again use the procedure. There are analytical solutions available for the this problem also. But we at undergraduate level we solve problem using the Heisler and the Grober chart. And the first step we calculate the Biot number. So for a cylinder HRO by K, where H is the heat transfer coefficient and the K is the thermal conductivity of the material. And you calculate the dimensionless position, small r by capital RO. RO is the outer radius and small r is the any given radius. Then calculate the Fourier number, which is alpha T by RO square. Then from the Heisler chart, take the temperature distribution at the center. So the temperature distribution at the center, TO minus T infinity divided by TI minus T infinity is a function of Biot number and the Fourier number. And this is the temperature history at the center of the cylinder. So the x-axis is Fourier number, which is alpha T by RO square. And the y-axis is the temperature ratio. So TO minus T infinity divided by TI minus T infinity. And the lines for different values of the Biot number HRO by K. And here again, the Fourier number from 0.1 to 35. So if the Fourier number is within this range, 0.1 to 35, we can comfortably use the chart for calculating the temperature distribution. And if you want to calculate the temperature at any given position, so from the Heisler chart, take the temperature distribution to calculate the temperature at any position within the cylinder. So here the temperature ratio is a function of Biot number and the non-dimensional position ratio R by RO. So T minus T infinity divided by TO minus T infinity equal to a function of Biot number into dimensionless radius ratio. Here the TO is from the previous calculation, center temperature from the previous calculation. And this is the long cylinder temperature time history at any given radius R. The x-axis is Biot number HRO by K. And the y-axis is the temperature ratio and the line for different values of R by RO. So 0.2 to 1. So one for the outer surface of the cylinder and two is near the center of the cylinder from the axis. Then the to determine the heat transfer, so first you have to calculate the QO, the calculate the initial internal energy of the cylinder with respect to the ambient temperature. Rho is the density, C is the specific heat of the cylinder material, and V is the volume of the cylinder. So QO equal to rho CV into Ti minus T infinity. And using the Grober chart, we have to take the Q by QO ratio, so which is the function of Biot number square into Fourier number and Biot number. So Q by QO is a function of Biot number square and Fourier number into and Biot number. Now this is the Grober chart for the long cylinder. X axis Biot number square into Fourier number and Y axis Q by QO ratio and the lines for different values of the Biot number. So knowing any two parameters, you can calculate the third parameter. So Q by QO, normally Q by QO is the unknown. So use this ratio Biot number and Fourier number, you can find out this ratio. Now we take one numerical example. Estimate the time required to cook a fish in boiling water. Assume that fish is initially at 60 degrees Celsius. The convective heat transfer coefficient is 100 watts per meter square Kelvin and the final temperature is 80 degrees Celsius at the center line. Treat the fish as a long cylinder of 40 mm diameter having the following properties. Rho equal to 80 kilograms per meter cube. Specific heat equal to 3350 joules per kilogram Kelvin and thermal conductivity is 0.52 watts per meter Kelvin. In the given data, the radius of the cylinder, radius of this fish is equal to 0.02 meter. Diameter is given as 40 mm. So radius equal to 0.02 meter. Thermal conductivity is 0.52. Rho density equal to 880 kilograms per meter cube. Specific heat is 3350 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Alpha equal to K by rho C, which is 1.76 10 power minus 7 meter square per second. Initial temperature is 6 degrees Celsius. Heat transfer coefficient is 100 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the central line temperature TO equal to 80 degrees Celsius. And we take T infinity. So it is boiling water. So boiling water, the fluid temperature is taken as 100 degrees Celsius. And calculate Biot number. Biot number equal to HRO by K equal to 100 into 0.02 divided by 50. Which is 3.8. Then we calculate the temperature at the center. So TO minus T infinity divided by TI minus T infinity equal to 80 minus 100 divided by 6 minus 100 equal to 0.2. The temperature ratio at the center is 0.2 and the Biot number is 3.8. Now the temperature ratio is 0.2 and Biot number is 3.8. Now for the use this graph, long cylinder temperature time history at the center line. So the 0.2, you draw the horizontal line, it will meet the Biot number at the 0.3.8, then you draw the vertical line, so the Fourier number is 0.6. So for this problem, the Fourier number is 0.6, and from the Fourier number, we can calculate the time required to cook the fish. So from the Fourier number, alpha T by RO square equal to 1.76 in 10 power minus 7 into time T divided by RO equal to 0.02 square, which is equal to 0.6. So solving the time equal to 1363.6 seconds. And the time required to cook the fish is 1363.6 seconds. This is the answer to the problem. And if we take another example, a 2 meter long 0.2 meter diameter steel cylinder of alpha equal to 1 in 10 power 5 meter square per second, K thermal conductivity is 40 watts per meter Kelvin. Initially at 400 degrees Celsius, is suddenly immersed in water at 50 degrees Celsius. If the unit surface conductance is 200 watts per meter square Kelvin, that is heat transfer coefficient, calculate 20 minutes after immersion. 1. Center temperature. 2. Surface temperature. 3. Heat transfer to the water during 20 minutes. So the given data, outer radius. So diameter is given as 0.2 meter, outer radius equal to 0.1 meter, length of the cylinder is 2 meter, thermal conductivity is 40 watts per meter Kelvin, thermal diffusivity alpha equal to 1 into 10 power minus 5 meter square per second, and the initial temperature is 400 degrees Celsius, heat transfer coefficient is 200 watts per meter square Kelvin, the fluid temperature is 50 degrees Celsius, and the time is 20 minutes, which is 1200 seconds. So calculating the Biot number, so Biot number equal to HRO by K, which is 200 into 0.1 divided by 40 equal to 0.5, and calculating the Fourier number. So alpha t by r o square equal to 1 into 10 power minus 5 into 1200 will be 0.1 square equal to 1.2. Now to calculate the center line temperature, so you refer to this Heisler chart. So Biot number is 0.5 and Fourier number is 1.2. So Biot number 0.5, you draw a vertical line and it will meet the Fourier number 1.2, draw a vertical line, it will meet the Biot number at 0.5, and here the temperature ratio is 0.42. So TO minus T infinity divided by TI minus T infinity equal to TO minus 50 divided by 400 minus 50 equal to 0.42. So TO equal to 50 plus 0.42 into 350, which is 197 degree Celsius. So the temperature at the center after 20 minutes is 197 degree Celsius. And to calculate the temperature at the surface, we refer the Heisler chart temperature time history at the radius r, any radius r. So here the Biot number is 0.5, the dimensionless position at surface x by l equal to 1. So for the Biot number 0.5, you draw a vertical line. So it will meet the x by l ratio 1, and the corresponding ratio is TRO minus T infinity divided by TO minus T infinity equal to TRO minus 50 divided by 197 minus 50 equal to 0.78. So this 197 center temperature from the previous calculation. So TRO equal to 50 plus 0.78 into 147 equal to 164.66 degree Celsius. And to calculate the heat transfer coefficient, total amount of heat transfer, so you refer to the Grober chart. So we calculate the Biot number square into Fourier number, which is 0.5 square into 1.2 equal to 0.3, and Biot number is 0.5. So for the Biot number square Fourier number, you 0.3, you draw a vertical line, it will meet the 0.5 line at this point, and this Q by QO ratio is 0.4. So Q by QO ratio from the Grober chart is 0.4. So from here you can calculate the amount of heat transfer from the cylinder. The heat transfer from the cylinder to the water, so Q equal to 0.4 times of QO, which is 0.4 into rho C into pi r o square into L into T A minus T infinity. So pi r o square into L is the area of the volume of the cylinder. So 0.4 into this rho C equal to alpha K by alpha. So 40 divided by 1 into 10 power minus 5 into pi into 0.1 square into 2 into 400 minus 50 equal to 3.5 to 10 power 7 watts. So the answer to the problem, temperature at the center is 197 degree Celsius, temperature at the surface is 164.66 degree Celsius, and amount of heat transferred to the water is 3.5 to 10 power 7 watts. And these are all the reference book I used for the preparation, so you can refer to it for additional information. And this is the book what I have published in the subject. You can refer to it for additional problems on the subject on the long cylinder. And you can write to me to my mail ID for any clarification. I will sincerely answer. And thank you. We'll meet again.